All right, so we're just about done here this morning. The next breakout sessions are going to start at 11, but before we head to that, the first breakout session on this stage is something that I think you're all going to be interested to hear about, so we wanted to make sure you at least get a nugget of it today. You heard today about energy, about education, food, technology. It's all part of a huge global ecosystem, but where in the world is it best to be an entrepreneur? Where is it best to be changing the world from? I'm excited to introduce Monique Villa from the Thomson Reuters Foundation, who will talk about their recent study on entrepreneur ecosystems around the world.
Good morning, SOCAP. I must say it's really good to be here today with so many thought leaders and change makers. I hope you don't all leave the room when we start. It's also great to be here and not to have to explain what is a social enterprise, because of course you know. And I can only imagine that it must be the story of your life, having to explain again and again that you are doing what you are doing is running a business that solves social problems, and that you are not a charity. I love the way one of the experts put it in the poll that I'm going to present now. He says, just mentioning the word social makes investors dumb, deaf, and blind. It doesn't have to be that way, of course, and that is precisely why we partnered with Deutsche Bank Unlimited and the Global Social Entrepreneurship Network to develop an innovative poll that would raise awareness on the fantastic work you do, all of you. This poll is unique because it ranks the best countries to be a social entrepreneur and sheds light on the opportunities and the challenges that you have. Our survey is global. We spoke to almost 900 experts in the world's 45 biggest economies, social entrepreneurs, but also investors, as you can see, academics and policymakers. And we asked them 12 questions. These questions cover a number of specific areas with the ultimate goal to understand how easy it is for you to start and grow a social enterprise in your own countries. The questions range from whether you can access capital, mentoring, and other services easily, if you can make a living out of your business, if the products and services you produce are easy or not to sell and market. We developed these questions by consulting many organizations active in the field, and some of them are in the room today. So what did we find out? Well, the ranking revealed a few surprises, but, you know, the top is not surprising. The best three countries are US, Canada, and Great Britain. But throughout, it was very interesting to see that, for instance, Chile and Malaysia performed very strongly among the top 10. And also to see countries such as Sweden or Brazil or Australia ranking at the lower end. Our poll also identified five hotspots. And these hotspots are Santiago, Nairobi, Hong Kong, Berlin and London. And in the UK, we have seen that investors start to be pretty worried that Brexit could stop the growth of the sector. We also use this poll as an opportunity to take a look at how women are doing in the social entrepreneurship world. We looked at two things: whether women are well represented in management, and whether they are paid the same as men. Two crucial issues for women, as we all know. The results are fascinating. Asia came at the top, and the Philippines are leading, with behind Malaysia, China, Hong Kong, Indonesia, and Thailand. was polling also very strongly. It looks that if you are a woman in this sector, your best place is Asia. These countries are leading the way for social entrepreneurs to thrive and succeed and can show the rest of the world how to encourage such a vital business sector. And that's our hope, that this poll will provide the leaders and change makers of today with the tools they need to continue to explore more innovative ways of doing business for good. Join us at 11 in this same room, because we will have a fantastic session and Q&A about this poll with very good speakers. But before I go, let me just answer quickly the question that I'm sure a few of you are asking themselves now. What is the link between the Thomson Reuters Foundation and social entrepreneurship? The answer is very simple. At the foundation, we run four programs that offer free services for NGOs and social enterprise. One of them is Trust Law. Trust Law is the largest pro bono legal service in the world. Through Trust Law, your social enterprise has access to the best lawyers and to their brain for free, for anything that you need. And it is what I call an impact multiplier, because that way social entrepreneurs can focus on their mission and don't have to spend on a lawyer, and you can benefit from their intelligence but also from their advice. Through Trust Law that I created in 2010, and which today has 3,400 members, of which 600 law firms in 170 countries, we have supported hundreds of social entrepreneurs to employ their staff members, to expand other countries, to navigate the complexity of regulations, to solve their IP issues, their HR issues, etc. So if you are not a member yet, have a look at Trust Law. Just two days ago, we held a training for lawyers here in San Francisco to help them understand better social enterprise and impact investing. And the response has been huge. There were 50 of them, and we will be running the same course in London in October, but we have done it in New York and elsewhere. So as I thank SOCAP for this great opportunity to present you this poll, I would like to encourage those who would like to know more to stay with us and to visit the website trust.org, where it is the website of the foundation, and the poll is there with a lot of interesting articles from our team of journalists. So join us here at 11. And we will have an in-depth look at the findings and interesting discussion. Thank you very much. See you later.